everybody. It is day 3 of Vlogmas. Yes. Okay. So, I had some video footage that I wanted to upload and everything, but I'm kind of out doing my second job right now, and so I didn't have time to really put it all together like I really want to. So, I said, "Okay, I'll just do a quick video." Oh, Lord, is this lash acting ugly? Anyway, so I just want to say good evening to everyone. I hope everyone is having an awesome Tuesday. And I just wanted to come talk to you guys. Thank everybody for the last couple of videos. I'm really trying to hang in here with this Vlogmas, you guys. I think it's giving me something to do every day and look forward to doing something every day. You know what I'm saying? So, keep in mind, If I put on their lost footage or previous footage or what have you, if you see footage of me with the black hair, you know I don't have black hair anymore, just know that that was, you know, previously recorded. I just never got a chance to upload it on YouTube because I was being lazy. Yeah, that's basically what it boils down to. I was being lazy, okay? So this is giving me a chance to take all that footage and everything I have in my phone and upload it and everything. So I got a couple of days worth of footage in my phone. So I will be releasing some additional videos, of course, every day. I'm trying to do it every day. I'm trying to really stick to this, okay? So so I want to thank everybody for the last couple of days for your comments, your likes, your views, and what have you. I know this is me like starting all over again, but I appreciate you guys for coming through and showing your girl some love. You know what I'm saying? Thank you. I appreciate it. But I wanted to come and talk to you guys about, I just met a young lady, but you know, she's an older lady or what have you. And, she was telling me about a year ago, she fell and bust her head or what have you, cracked her head, whatever, it has caused her to now have seizures. She's had like 3 or 4 seizures within a year, and she no longer can drive. And she said her level of gratitude now is just so, you know, just so through the roof. I guess because she's now dependent on other people to do things for her, what have you, whereas previously she didn't have to, you know, deal with that type of stuff. And it, you know, it makes you just put so many different things in perspective. You know, I deal with certain things, you know, my friends, we all have certain things that we deal with or what have you. Some, you know, a little more extreme than others, but whatever, you know, it's just life. But I find myself a lot of times, and I try to pull myself out of it. Sometimes it's very, very difficult to do. You know, I find myself just, when something just bogs me down, I'm like, I'm talking about it bogs me down. And I shut down, you know, and I have to think about, you know, just listening to the, you know, to the lady talk made me just think about, you know what, Cheryl, the things you be, you know, not saying that the things I go through is so minute and what have, you know, just a little small, but it was one thing to, okay, I'm dealing with this, blah, 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 you know, rant, call your girlfriends, get it off your chest, or whoever you got to call, your best friends, whatever, and get it off your chest, but don't dwell and mope and, just stick in it, you know, all the time, what have you. I have so many, instead of focusing on so many things that I don't have, or a place in life that I wish, you know, right now that where I'm not pleased, but, you know, from where I would like to be at the age of 44, is like, man, I saw so much different for my life, you know, 20 years ago, you know, by 44, I was expecting something totally different. but like me and my best friend say all the time, what my best friend tells me all the time, this is the ish they didn't tell us when we was younger, how this adult thing was going to work. You know what I'm saying? But I do, you know, instead of moping and griping and shutting down like I do, I'm going to try to be a little bit more grateful, because I mean, this year has been rough, but just last month, October, I was just on a cruise ship, a Carnival Magic cruise ship with my family. You know, it's a lot of people that never been on a cruise, maybe don't want to go on a cruise, but can't go on a cruise, things like that. And I've been on one and look, baby, ready to sign, ready for my dad to contact me and let me know what we're going to do for next year. Because we're going on the Royal Caribbean. So that's more footage I have in my phone, you guys, that I'm going to upload my trip to on the cruise to the Bahamas, Grand Turks, and Dominican Republic. So look forward to that. But, I was just thinking, you know, I go back and look at some of those pictures, and I remember when I was on the cruise, we had a balcony room, and I remember when I would sit out on that balcony and hear the beautiful waves and the ocean, and, you know, just at nighttime, it just looked really beautiful, and you could see other cruise ships, you know, just miles away, but, you know, cruise ships are so lit up, it just looks so beautiful at night, and I remember just recording the water. I remember recording the water during the daytime when we would be out on the deck. And I remember saying to myself, I want to video all this for those days and those times when I find myself just, you know, like, oh my God, life is over. You know, oh, I'm going through this or whatever. When I find myself wanting to complain, go back to this footage. You know what I'm saying? Go back to this time. You know what I'm saying? And just think about, you know, the blessing and everything that came with that, you know. So, because there wasn't nobody but God, honey. What? I mean, I'm telling you, I've been wanting to go on a cruise for the longest and what have you, but I've, you know, just never got a chance to go around. So I'm grateful for my dad and my bonus mom for reaching out to everybody, friends and family, to go celebrate their 25 years of marriage on this cruise with them. Like I said, it was a once in a lifetime, beautiful experience that I'm looking forward to October next year or whenever we supposed to go for next year. But, you guys, I just want to give a message. I know it's the holiday season and, you know, but this is a speech, this is something that should be just, you know, talked about and practiced on a daily basis. You know, there are a lot of you out there that have, you know, husband and wives that you find that you're not showing appreciation to. Trust me, I know, because I talked with a few. I've been a truck driver and I've ran team with both male and one female. But, you know, men feel unappreciated too, ladies. And I know, you know, I get a lot of my friends that are married, you know, they talk about, you know, what they blah, 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 blah. But sometimes men feel that, you know, unappreciated sometimes too. But I just say I think we should just learn to practice a little being grateful for having a significant other, for having a spouse, for having someone to go home to, you know, at night to chit chat with, to, you know, to pamper you or whatever when you're sick, you know, stuff like that. Because, baby, this single life sometime ain't necessarily what's up. You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying. But trust me, and I'm not rushing anything either. But, you know, I'm just saying. I think it's a blessing to be able to come home and have somebody to, you know, to talk to. And also, if you live in a city where your family is right there. You know, I'm here in Dallas. My mom, dad, sisters, brothers, they're all in Kansas City. So, you know, I've kind of missed that a little bit. And then I have other family that's in Shreveport. Now here in Dallas, I have a lot of cousins that I'm telling you that I am totally grateful for, totally grateful for. I really am. But you know, when you have your mom and dad and they're getting older and stuff like that, you know, you need to learn to, I don't know about anybody else, learn to appreciate them more and things like that. So when the lady was just talking about how grateful she is for every little thing now because of what happened to her, I'm thinking to myself, man, I don't want to put that out in the universe. I don't want anything to happen to me for me to feel grateful about of the things that God has blessed me with. I mean, literally, I'm just saying, you know, car and roof over my head. A lot of people don't have that, you know. Son that is, you know, healthy and doing his thing. I'm grateful for that. You know, some people have to, you know, visit their son or daughters or kids behind bars or different things like that. And I'm just like, oh my God, you know, but they probably are grateful for that than the other alternative. You know what I'm saying? So, I just think it's just, a good thing to practice gratitude on a daily basis as often as possible, because I am truly a believer in that type of energy and what have you, you put out there is something that would definitely come back to you. And so I just think that we ought to just, you know, take the time to just, you know, tell your loved ones you love them, hug your kids, you know, make a phone call to that person who you're mad at, who you thought was mad at you or you're mad at or what have you. You know, sometimes things are not even worth the energy of being so upset about, and, you know, and it's, you know, it's just not worth it. It really is not worth it. So I would say let's all be more grateful and giving, definitely more giving, and have a, you know, a giving heart. Pay it forward. A lot of things, a lot of blessings that I've received in my life, when if I ever have the chance, I tell you, I pay stuff forward, because I'm being honest with y'all. I have been blessed. I really have. Like I said, me sitting up here talking about it now is getting me teared up, but I'm just being honest. You know, when I feel like I want to just be down about stuff, when I really look over something, just really take a close look at stuff, I've been truly blessed. So, yeah, so call your spouses, your loved ones, hug them, kiss them, and all that good stuff. If you have kids, give them a call, give them a hug. So that's all I'm going to bring in this vlog. Look forward to more vlogs throughout the week. And why is this person slowing down in front of me? I don't know. But, I mean, we're in 2019, y'all. It should not surprise anybody now to see a tripod, a camera, the light on in a car, you know, this, that, the other, blah, blah, blah. That, you know, it probably throw you off for a minute, but that's, oh, that person is vlogging, or that person is either FaceTiming somebody or something like that. I mean, you know how it go. But anywho, I'm going to go ahead and end this vlog here. I'd like to thank everybody for your comments and likes and views for the last couple of videos. I look forward to chatting with you in the comments section. And all my drivers, be safe out there. And to all my new subscribers, because I have now engaged with a lot of family channels now. I'm really enjoying that. And so I know a few of the ladies of the family channels and what have you have now subscribed to my channel. So I'd like to welcome you ladies. This is the life of a lady truck driver. But I want to do more than just send, but this was just kind of impromptu. I wanted to do a video real quick because I wasn't at home in order to upload some footage. So, but I'll get all that together for the, later on tonight. So I want to upload a little sooner than, 8:25 at night. You know what I'm saying? So hopefully I can get these videos out, but I just want to make sure I get them out before midnight. So it counts towards that day. You know what I'm saying? Okay, everybody. Love you. Hugs. Give me a hug. Bye-bye.